Okay, good evening everybody, and welcome to this second virtual dance class and meetup organized by Modern Jive Surrey. So now that we are officially in lockdown, more than ever we need to support each other, cheer each other up and keep fit. So no excuse to let ourselves down, and tonight we're going to do a bit of dancing and hopefully you're going to have some fun as well. So I need to share with you...
This is great, this, because we can see all your faces.
Bye! Hello.
Terrible thought.
Share with you so you can see the program of the evening. And, oops. There we go. So, tonight's program, we've got welcome, housekeeping and tips. That's already started. At 8:05, the beginner's lesson. Then we will have a virtual social catch-up, just 5 minutes. To, you know, see how it's going for everyone. Then we will have a lesson on the JoJo Tango with Christine Ellis. I had written Ellis, I don't know where it's disappeared. And then we will have a dance quiz with Rob and Diane. Thank you for organizing this. The Va Va Voom stroll will follow. We've done it last week. And we will finish with a Q&A, question and answer, and your feedback, as we did last time. So, for the housekeeping, I'm going to ask Christelle to jump in and give us the ground rules.
Okay, so just to a few tips here, guys. You have been muted. It's just to avoid a high volume of background noise. When there's so many of us, it makes a lot of noise otherwise. However, you can interact with us via the chat on the right-hand side of your screen. If you're using a phone, if you're using a laptop, the chat comes at the bottom of the screen in the middle. Feel free to comment, to ask a question, to use the reactions buttons as well. There's the clap or the thumbs up, and there's also the raise your hand icon, so we know that you're still here and maybe you want to speak or say something. The Modern Jive Surrey team is here to respond and keep this session alive. This session will be recorded so you can practice the dance activities again and again. Just a word of caution, when you engage in one of the exercises that we are going to offer you, please only do what you can do and do not take Do not take any risks while doing the exercises. You are doing the exercises at your own risk, since we're not able to monitor that you're doing them correctly, obviously. To dance properly, you need a smooth surface, such as wood flooring. Carpet is not good and it doesn't allow your feet to turn, so you can end up with bad knees. Make sure you have some water at hand, as rehydration is very important. And if at any time you're not feeling well while doing the dance activities, please just stop and have a rest. And remember that this is recorded anyway, so you'll be able to go back to the session and watch it over and over again and practice the exercises as much as you like. Obviously, Modern Jive is a partner dance, but most people watching will be on their own at home. So we will be offering mainly, if not exclusively, activities that can be done alone, like strolls and things like that. At the end of this session, we will ask you for some feedback, and we would be grateful if you could let us know what worked well for you or what did not work so well, what you'd like more of or less of, so that we can adapt for the future weeks. A few tips for a great online lesson. So make sure you're muted when you're not talking, especially if you are two of you watching this. People don't realize, but when you interact with your partner, we can hear absolutely everything. So remain muted, please. Ask questions using the chat box. So as we said, it's going to be on the right-hand side on the phone or at the bottom on the laptop. Use the reactions boxes to engage with everyone, like your clap, the thumbs up and all that. We can all see that people are using the chat right now. There are 7 messages on my laptop. Think before you write, and use the raise your hand feature if you want to ask a question live, and then we'll unmute you and then you can talk. There you go, that's it.
Okay, fantastic. So just the raise your hand is by the chat. Yes, check everyone is muted, did you say? Emma is asking me something. I'm just going to go back to, I'm just going to stop the this for a moment. Okay, actually, no, we're going to go straight into the beginner's lesson, and we will do a little warm up. So this is the time when we all stand up, and we're going to use our feet, and why not our arms as well? Okay, we need to move things around. This is our lounge, and I just need to make sure that you're going to see. Right. That's normal. Pin. That's it. So Emma, if you go over there, we're going to start. So everybody up. And I think it's fine, more or less. Yes. It's because we've got that's fine. Right. So we are going to do a small warm-up. So if you follow us as well, all we need to do is step back on your right foot. You're going to replace the weight on the left. You're going to step forward on your right. Pivot, half a turn. You're going to go back left and back right. Okay, one more time. Okay, we can keep playing like this. So we're going back, replace, forward right, pivot, back, back. Okay, and again. So by the way, at all time, you will be you will be facing your computer screen. Okay, here we go again. Back, replace, forward, back, back. I think you can do it. We're going to add a second bit, so we're doing that one last time. Back and turn towards your screen, and then back, back. Now we're going to do the second part of this exercise. So you're going to go replace the weight on the left foot, go forward with the right, to the side, face your screen, and then go back. Let's do the second bit again. So we're going back, replace, forward, side, back. So we're always turning towards our screen. The whole thing, let's try. Ready? And one, and two, and three, and four, and one. Well, one, I think it's looking good. The people I can see, yes, you're doing it. Excellent. Oh, a bit faster, ready? And one, and two, and three, and four, and one, and two, and three, and four, and one. And again, two, and three, and four, and back. I lost the pound. I turned the wrong way by the end. Just checking you're following. So let's try this to music. I'm going to get some music. Just bear with me a second. I'm going into the, find some lessons.
Alan, we can only see the top of your head.
You can only see the top of my head. It's okay. It's
Alan, not Thierry.
It's a while. I promise.
Ah, that's better, Alan.
Is it loud enough?
Yes.
Yeah. Okay. After rest. Bye.
You know that it would be untrue. You know that I would be a liar if I was to say to you, yeah, we could get much higher. Come on, baby, light my fire. Come on, baby, light my fire. Try to set the night on fire. Oh, time.
Okay, so I'm aware that you can only see, oh no, that's okay, you can see me.
Hey, thanks, Julie.
So, stay up, we are going to do, now the beginner's lesson. we can see Christelle.
Sorry, Grizzly is being very rude, Thierry.
Who has?
Grizzly, alias Stuart. Stuart.
Oh dear. So, we are going to start with the look hole, and it looks like this. I think you can't see my face every time. So you have to see either our feet or our face, but you can't have both tonight. I don't know why. So, we're going to show you the look hole with a man going through first. It looks like this. One, and two, and three, and four, and one. Have you noticed? This was your warm-up, so even if you're on your own, you can still do the move. So for this move, we will be offset. So ladies, you're going to learn your part on your own. Gentlemen, you're going to learn your part on your own too. And then if you're on your own at home, you will have to dance with the invisible man or the invisible woman.
Or a broom.
Or a broom. Yes. The invisible
yes.
broom.
Yes.
So, this is a double-handed move, so we are offering the hands at the lady's hip level, okay? But we are separated. If you are together, you can do it together. If you are, two people, then.
And for those of you who've been dancing a while, you can always switch, so the leaders could become the followers and the followers could try the leaders' part.
Exactly. So
I want to see what Stuart does that.
We're both leading towards our partner and we're stepping back, okay? From here, we are both going to turn towards your screen, your device screen, okay? So I'm going to turn away from you, both of us, we're going to turn away. As you do this, you're going to raise your right hand and place it over your head. Now, thank you, Emma. From here, we're going to continue turning, take a small step back. I'm talking for the gentleman, by the way. Small step back left and a step back with the right foot. So let's focus on the man's footwork one more time and then Emma will explain what's happening. So we're leading the lady back and then we're going to wrap ourselves with our right arm up. We continue turning, we lower the right arm as we step back left, right. Now, what's happening for the ladies, Emma?
Ladies, pretty much what we've practiced just now. So for us, we're going to take a small step back on our right foot. We're going to come forward on our left foot. We're going to turn towards the screen with our right foot. We're going to continue turning, so step onto our left foot, and then we're going to step back right foot. So small step back to the right.
One more time.
So, ladies, small step back on the right foot. You're going to put the weight onto your left foot. You're going to come forward on your right. So you're going to pivot, continue turning, and then a small step back on your right foot.
Excellent. That takes us to the second part. So for the second part, we're both stepping back right. Guys, you're going to wrap the lady this time. So you're going to take your left hand over the lady's head as you step forward with the right foot. Step behind the lady, lower the hand and step back right. Let's do this again. So we're leading the lady back and taking a step back with the right foot. We're going to lead the lady towards ourselves, we step out of the lady's way and step forward with the right foot, step behind the lady with the left foot and back right. And that's the man's part. Now, what's happening for the ladies?
So for the ladies, we're going to step back on our right foot, going to replace the weight onto our left foot, and we're going to face, so if you guys are going to face towards the screen again. So we're going to step across with our right foot, and then we're going to step, small step back with our left foot, small step back right. So we finished, Tammy.
Yeah, excellent. Number of beats, follow Emma, ladies, or followers, and leaders, follow me. Ready? It will look like this. We'll show you. One, and two, and three, and four, and one. Let's try together. Ready, and one, and two, and three, and four, and one. Now we're going to dance it together to music, but please feel free to do it even on your own and focus on...
Kira, I'm sorry to say, they're all taking the mickey out of your impromptu curtains in the background.
Don't you like them?
I don't want to grass anybody or say names, but it was Stuart and Emily, really.
The curtain. Well, it's actually that we haven't had any curtains for a couple of years.
So curtains, promise.
Maybe not for next week.
Maybe we should ask for some for my birthday.
Yes, exactly. Emma's birthday. You can buy her curtain. She will be delighted, I'm sure. Okay. I'm going to put some music and we'll do this together. I'm going to try something a bit, not too slow, but not too fast either. Right. This is on the slower end.
You've been doing to me.
Five, six, seven, eight.
I'm falling over myself just to be at your window.
So we're gonna do this over and over again. Ready?
I'm painting pictures of your beautiful face. I'm dropping everything to cover your safe. Holding you closer to me couldn't be any better.
One, and two, and three, and four. How did it go? Can I see some thumbs up or no?
Where's Darren?
Swapping the lead. Does anyone have the ladies leading and the men's following?
That's the situation. Okay, that takes us to the second move of the routine, and it's the neck break. It looks like this. So we extend the right arm, we lead the lady into our right hand side, transfer the lady's hand from our left to our right. We send the lady forward and step back. So we're going to split again, but this time Emma is on the opposite side. So we are starting with the left hand nice and low. It's a left to right hand move. So we're going to lean towards our partner and away as we extend the right arm. So we end up like this. And if I do it your way, that's what it should look like. And what's happening for the ladies?
So for the ladies, we're basically being led, so we're going to step back on our right foot, small step back.
Okay. From here, gentlemen, you're going to lean towards you as you step out of the way.
So ladies, we're going to replace the weight onto our left foot.
And step forward on your right foot.
And ladies, are also stepping forward on our right foot.
So let's try this one more time. We're going back right, replace, and forward. Now, we're going to replace the weight on the left foot, which is behind. And as we do this, we're going to transfer the lady's hand from our left hand into our right hand, the extended arm. So we replace the weight on the back foot, transfer the hand, and step back right. Okay, one more time. And then Emma will explain what the ladies are doing. So from the beginning, we're going back, replace, forward. As we replace the weight onto the back foot, the left foot, we transfer the lady's hand from our left hand into our right hand and step back. Now, Emma, what's happening for the ladies?
So, ladies, we are taking a small step back on our right foot, then we're going to replace the weight onto our left foot, we're going to take a step forward onto our right foot. Now what we're going to do here is we're going to take another step onto our left foot, and as we do so, we're pivoting on that left foot. So we're going to pivot, and we're going to step back with our right foot. And
that's where we have been up to.
So let's do that one more time. So ladies, you're going to take a small step back on your right foot, replace the weight on your left, come forward on your right, forward on your left, and then you're going to pivot on your left foot. So pivot on your left foot, step back on your right foot.
Now the exit, we can finish this move actually.
So we're both back on our right foot at the moment.
So just watch what's going to happen if you were with a partner. We would be here, and we nudge the lady forward with our right arm, or our whole body in reality. The left hand can go on the lady's left shoulder blade, the nearest to us, and we just nudge her up as we step back into her slot, and step back in and then back. So let's do this together. This is where we ended up. So we had transferred the lady's hand, and we're both back on our right foot. We're going to transfer the weight onto our front foot. Then we're going to step forward, both of us, with our right foot. Now, guys, you're going to apply some pressure. You're going to raise the right arm. You can nudge the lady with the left as well. And you step forward to follow the lady, forward left. And then we're going to lower the hand and both step back. One more time from the opening. So this is where we were. We replace the weight onto the front foot, step forward with the right, nudge the lady out as you step forward, gentlemen, lower the hand and step back. Excellent. So, the whole move, we'll show you with a bead what it looks like. Actually, we'll be facing you so you can see. Yes, this is Emma's bottom. Ready, and one, and two, and three, and four, and five. And you see I'm hiding behind Emma because I'm on her track. So I wasn't rude, was I? I did very well then. So let's do this separately but together. Ready, and one, and two, transfer, and three, and turn the lady and back. One more time. Ready, and one, and two, and three. Okay.
Wrong way.
Ready, and one, and two, and three, and four, and back. Okay, together, and slightly faster after eight. Five, six, seven, eight. One, and two, and three, and four, and back to music. So either you're with a partner, you can do it definitely to the music. Sorry, I said, let's do something different. Play. Is going fast. So you finish right to right. All we need to do is lead the lady back. We're going to comb the lady's hair. Make sure you don't touch.
Careful with the hair.
They can't see your head. Okay, all right. From here, we're going to trace the lady's left shoulder and the lady's right shoulder, both arms, and we're going to finish double-handed. You can do ripples. Okay, so one more time. You can do it on your own anyway. Right to right, so we just step back, replace the weight, comb the lady. We can tap to the side wherever you like. Comb, offer both hands and back. It's a very quick move. It goes one, and two and three. So let's link this to the previous move, and then we'll do the whole routine. Left to right, ready, hand. Into the side, transfer the hand, and lunge, bend the lead leg, and back. From here, we step in, comb the lady, and back to two hands. We are going to do it one more time, and then we'll link the first move to the other three. Ready, and one, and two, and three, and four, and one, and two, and one. Excellent. Shall we do it to music? Just these two, and then we will be adding more. The first move. Okay. Da-da-da. I should have changed, chosen the music before.
The comments are brilliant, Thierry. What a shame you're missing.
That's right. Leave a step on the side. Afraid. Five, six, seven, eight, and one, and two, and three, and four, and
I can stop
one,
shaking.
And
the green is a groove in the floor.
One more time.
It's almost
a
twinkle.
Five, six, seven, eight,
and
one. Okay, we're just going to link a quick refresh and then we'll do the whole thing.
Who can remember what the first move was?
No. It's called the loophole with a back through first. So offer both hands and lean the lady back. Wrap yourselves, guys. Let go and back. Wrap the lady and let go with the right hand, but immediately offer it at shoulder level. Lead the lady into it for the neck break. Woo. And exit the lady.
And now we have to count.
Back to two hands.
Double handed, ready to go around again.
So, to music. I was going to say with this partner, but if you.
People are dancing with cats.
Always swap. Sorry, Christelle, were you talking?
Yes, I was saying some people are dancing with cats.
Ah, fabulous. Some people are dancing with their cats.
Yeah. Oh.
Okay. So, here we go. Five, six, seven, eight, and one, two, three, four. One, two, three, four. One, two, one. We're going to do it again. Two hands. After it. Five, six, seven,
why you took your pace
and one,
you reach your
and the
Okay, right, we're coming back. How are you feeling? You can unmute yourselves. Yes, good. Have you danced? I hope we can't see. Unfortunately, when we dance, we can't see everyone. Emma, do you want to come around here?
Yeah.
Okay. So, grab a glass of water, like this one. And that takes us to the next part. Let me have a look at what's happening next. Okay, so we've got, oh yes, before we do the next lesson, I need to unmute you all.
So,
and just, you can have a, we can have a little 5 minutes maybe where you can, anyone can join us. Tell us how it's going for you in this lockdown. How are you keeping fit? Are you still dancing at home? Just, you know, we've got 5 minutes to cool down and then we'll move on to the next lesson. Anyone, I've unmuted you, so anyone can talk.
I still can't dance
every day.
You can't dance. Oh, how is your ankle?
It was fine until I fell off a chair yesterday.
Oh, no.
So a bit of a setback.
He told you not to put vodka in your breakfast.
We have a problem here, so just to let you know, we can hear you just very in very low volume. I don't know what happened, it just started before we started the class tonight, so if we're not responsive all the time, it's because we can't hear you properly. But
and I'm a bit deaf anyway.
So yeah, no difference. Anyone else doing anything? You know, for example, my gym obviously is closed. They were very kind because they sent us a 2 month membership to Les Mills' online classes. And I've started this morning and I was quite pleased actually. I've done body balance, which was a mix of Tai Chi, so pushing things, and it's very gentle.
Nice.
Watch it.
It's very gentle, but by the end I was hurting. My core was hurting, my legs were hurting.
Oh,
anyone
God,
else? Christelle, where is Phoebe?
Go Wicks.
Someone
Go
Wicks
this morning.
Something.
Someone is talking.
Hello.
Oh,
hi.
Someone's going to be a lady, isn't it?
We're just very quiet.
Yeah, you were, but I'm
Keith and Milena.
Yeah, Keith and Milena.
Hi.
Keith and Milena. We
haven't seen you. We're at the bottom of the screen on my laptop. So they were trying
to find you. Oh, yes, yes, yes. Saw you guys.
Are they hiding?
Hey. There's quite a few people.
And Robin's joined
right.
us. Hi, Robin and Ivy.
Hi, Phoebe.
Hi.
Online. I've been doing yoga online.
What is Christine doing? Christine, can you talk to me? Just spread some bones. Okay.
She's holding the camera.
I think it's time to move on to the second lesson. We're way behind. It doesn't matter.
You're French, you're allowed.
Oh, that's good. So, the second lesson, it's called, oh, actually, I'm showing something, but you can see it. So, I'm going to share the screen and the audio. Right. Now, a bit of context here. We are quite serious about respecting, you know, social distancing policy. We were at the same time very keen to have Christine Ellis, who is, she runs a ballroom class school called Night and Day School of Dance. And she came to us on Saturday and she recorded a JoJo Tango class. Now, we won't say too much about it now, but if I can see, I can't see everyone and share the screen for some reason. Okay, so Christine, we'll be with you after the class. Everybody get ready to dance is your second class. And bear with me a second.
Christine, hurry up! You're late!
Whoops, sorry, I need to mute you all, otherwise you're not going to hear.
She's in the cloud, she's just joking, she's got a mask.
Manage participants.
Do I need a broom?
Mute all, okay. I'm going to mute you all so you can do the class. See you in about 7 minutes. So, here
we go. Christine, hurry up. You're late. You've got class to teach. They're waiting for you.
I haven't finished sweeping yet.
Well, hurry up.
You need me to teach a class now?
Yes, yeah, just now. Everybody's waiting. There's over 100 people waiting for you.
Okay. What am I teaching?
Do the Jojo Tango.
Jojo Tango.
Yes.
Okay. Right. What do I do? Start my left foot.
You start on your yes. Can you maybe can you face the other way so they can follow you?
Alright, so start on my left foot. Are you
yes.
Class ready?
I think we're all ready. We've been waiting for ages.
Okay, I'm doing it. Can't go any quicker.
Alright then, alright.
So we go left foot forward, right foot forward. Left foot forward, side, press. Left foot back, right foot back, left foot this side, and point. And we go rock, 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 pivot. Rock, 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 pivot. Forward side, behind, and rondé round. And start again.
Oh!
Shall I do it again?
Please do.
Okay. Left, right, left side drag. Left, right, left side point. Rock, 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 pivot. Rock, 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 pivot. Forward side, back, and rondé. I wish you'd told me I was going to do this. I wouldn't have worn my wellies.
You look amazing as always.
I just wore my dance shoes. I didn't know.
Well, it's okay. You know, social distancing. We have to be away from each other.
Well, yeah, I mean, you know, put my dance shoes. Look at me. I'm in my gardening gear.
Oh, you look amazing. Don't worry.
So, you want to do it again?
Can you do it one? Yes. Let's do the whole square and then all the walls. Yes. Yes.
Forward, forward, forward side drag, back, 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 and point. Rock, 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 pivot. Rock, 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 forward side, back, and rondé round. Forward, forward, forward side drag, left, right, left and point. Rock, rock, rock to the left. Rock, rock, rock to the right. And behind and rock, stay close.
Brilliant. Shall we do it to music?
Okay.
Is that all right? Careful, because
I'm windy here, and my toilet roll's going all over the place.
And your bra mask as well. It seems to be flying a bit.
It's not a bra. This is NHS mask.
Obviously, sorry. Can we just have a closer look at this wonderful? Very NHS-like. Okay, these days. Thank you. I noticed as well your teapot. You've got a lovely teapot. Look at this. What does it say? Night and day.
Made for me by Marion and Peter.
Oh. Beautiful. And the cup as well is very nice.
I've been drinking Dettol.
Dettol. That's why.
Yeah, they didn't have any milk in the shop. So they recommended Dettol.
Oh, fabulous.
Don't try it at home.
Don't try it at home. Okay. All right. Okay, so shall we do it to the music? Maybe if you start facing the garden. And make sure your loo roll is not flying away, please. Oh, not at all, not at all. It's tiny compared to the teapot.
Okay, that's
good. So, when the music stops, hang on, it starts, sorry.
Okay.
Christine. I'm sorry, doing the pivots on these slabs must have been quite something.
So, you know, you said to me, sweep the floor, and I didn't know, so here I am.
There you are, and you can continue sweeping the floor. We've got the lesson for Tuesday. Thank you ever so much, and we'll see you on Tuesday. Bye-bye. And with, and yes, with, yes, night and day dance as well. This is your school. And we hope to see you online. Pleasure. Bye-bye, Christine. Go back to your room.
Right.
Okay, so this is a standard lesson for Christine. Sorry, let me just stop sharing so I can see you. Right, have you done it? Yes, I can see some people have done it. Christine, I'm going to unmute yourself, and I would like to say, I can only see the top of, there you go. Can you speak to see if we can hear you?
Yeah. Hello.
Yes, we can hear you. So thank you very much for this, Jojo Tango. Actually, it was very good because there was, you taught a rondé, you taught some rocks, and there was maybe a salad stepping for some people, which was heel lead, but we couldn't go back to this in another lesson. When are your dance classes normally?
Who knows?
normally
Thursdays.
Normally Thursdays, and it's in?
Oh, Thursdays, Fridays. Thursdays at Cheam, Fridays at Nork.
Okay, brilliant. Thank you for joining us tonight. And it was lovely. I mean, we had so much fun. And I'm very sorry because it was really chilly that day. And I was inside, comfortable. And Christine was outside. And every time I was trying to film. And then there was always a problem with the music. So in the end, it took a bit longer. But by the end, she had swept the whole, the whole patio. So thank you for that, Christine.
Well, I haven't got a job now, you
see. By the way. I had to sweep the floor before.
Work where I can.
Okay, thank you very much, Christine. We're going to move on to the next part, and I have to remember what is the next part. Aha! Now, I'm not going to share the screen because the next part is the quiz. And for the quiz, the organizers this week are Rob and Diane. So, Rob and Diane, if you can. Oh, Emma has unmuted yourself.
No, they've unmuted themselves, but I just muted Christine.
Okay. It's okay. We can hear you, I think, Rob. So we're going to leave it to you to run the next sequence. Oh, do I need to... I haven't shared. I'm not sharing, am I?
Okay, so I'm going to share my screen.
You should be able to share because I haven't...
Can you see that?
Yay, there we are.
Yes. Yep. Oh.
What's it on again?
I'm going to mute us so that we don't interfere with your...
Nice to be able to hear.
Yeah, okay, where am I?
Okay, can you see that?
Hello?
No, we can't see it.
Yeah, no, when they speak, it does jump onto them. So yeah, if you guys speak...
Yeah, but yeah. PowerPoint.
Okay.
So you need to... Can you see my screen, everybody?
No, we can't. We can only see you.
Okay.
So can you hear Rob and Diane as well, could you?
Yes, I can hear them, but...
There we go.
You started sharing.
Yes, yes, okay. We can see your screen now, Rob.
You can see my screen?
Yes, we can.
Okay, now I'm going to go into the actual PowerPoint itself. So let's see if you can still hear me once I do that. Can you hear me?
Yes, we can hear you and we can see the PowerPoint.
We're going to go through the quiz now. There's 20 questions. If you'd like to grab yourself a pen and paper, then you can write your answers down against each numbered question. Okay, so
is that okay?
I'll just leave sort of 30 seconds whilst people grab a pen and paper. Okay, we're going to give the answers at the end of the quiz to see who scores the most. There's 20 questions, but there'll be 30 points. So some of the questions have got more than one answer. So you can get, you know, several points per question on some of them. So please don't call out the answers or add them to the chat window because that'll just be giving everybody else the answers. So is everybody ready? I want to put a thumbs up.
They're all muted. They're all muted, but yes, they're all pointing their thumbs.
Okay.
Right, so here we go then. Good luck to everybody. So here's question number one under the title of Let's Dance. So question number one. Which specific and non-specific dances are mentioned in the lyrics of Chris Montez's hit song, Let's Dance? And just to give you a clue, there's three specific dances and one non-specific dance. I don't know if you can remember the lyrics to that song. Okay. Let's move on to the next question. Right, question number two. Who had a 1983 transatlantic number one with a song that was also called Let's Dance? And there's a bit of a clue in the picture on the right-hand side of the screen there. Okay. Question number three. Which swing dance of the 1930s and 1940s is mentioned in Wham's hit Wake Me Up Before You Go Go? Question number four. Which dance sounds like a type of large eel? And there's a bit of a clue there. Question number five. Which dance is also a type of short jacket? And again, there's a clue. Question number six. Which dance did the New Zealand rugby team perform before their matches? Question number seven. This is under the title of Topical Music and Dance. So, who sent something beautiful to Radio 2's Joe Wiley last week? And again, there's a clue in the picture if you can work it out. Question number 8. Which couple won the 2019 series of Strictly Come Dancing? So there's 2 points on offer here, one for each of the 2 members of the couple. Okay, question number 9. Which country singer sadly passed away at the weekend? And there's a clue, the lyrics from one of his famous songs. Question number 10. Last week, the 2020 Glastonbury Festival was cancelled. If it had gone ahead, what anniversary would it have been celebrating? And then question number 11, who last headlined the festival in 2019? Right, now question number 12 under the heading of general music and dance. So this one is, who was the male 1958 Cha-Cha champion of Hong Kong? And that is actually him doing the dancing there, so you might recognize him. Question number 13. Noddy Holder, who was Slade's lead singer, bought his famous mirrored top hat from a young trader in Kensington Market, whose birth name was Farouk Bulsara. The young trader also became famous as a lead singer. What group was he frontman for? There's 2 points for this, one for the lead singer's name and one for the group. And there's a clue on the right-hand side there. Question number 14. Which group took its name from a medieval instrument of torture? And that is the particular instrument of torture on the left-hand side of the screen. Question number 15. Which group took its name from the inventor of the agricultural seed drill? Then question number 16, which Irish group took its name from a robot character in the comic The Dandy? Okay, only 4 more questions to go.
Thank goodness,
yeah. Question number 17. TV mogul Lou Grade's autobiography was titled Still Dancing. Which dance was he champion of in 1926? Is he world champion of in 1926? Question number 18. In 1980, Kelly Marie had a number one hit with the song Feels Like I'm in Love. It was written by an artist who had a transatlantic number one hit 10 years earlier in the summertime in 1970. Who is he and what is the name of the group he was lead singer of? 2 points for this question, one for the singer, one for the group. There's a clue on the right hand side there. Question 19. At South Croydon, we've all danced to a mashup and a remix of 2 songs that were massive hits in their own right. The first of these songs overtook the Righteous Brothers as the most played song on radio of all time, according to the BMI. The second song is the most played song in the 21st century, according to the licensing company PPL. What were the two original song titles and artists? And what is the title of the mashup track that we have danced to at South Croydon? Okay, so there's 5 points for this question. One for each of the artists, one for each song title, and one for the mashup song title. Okay, and then finally, the last question. Question number 20. Who sang, and this is basically the finish on a cheery note in these kind of trying times. Who sang the song, Don't Worry, Be Happy?
The song I wrote, might want to sing it note for note, don't worry, be happy. In every life we have some trouble. When you worry, you make it double, don't worry, be happy.
Okay, so does anybody need any questions repeated at all? No? Right, we'll move on to the answers. Now the answers. So number one, Let's Dance. So the specific and non-specific dances. So the three specific ones are the twist, the stomp, and the mashed potato. And the non-specific dance is any old dance that you want to do. So there's 4 points available there. If you want to mark yourself. So question number two, who had a 1983 transatlantic number one with a song also titled Let's Dance? That was David Bowie. Question number three, which swing dance of the 1930s and 1940s is mentioned in Wham's hit Wake Me Up Before You Go-Go? That's the jitterbug. Question four, the dance that sounds like a type of large eel is the conga. The dance that's a type of short jacket is the bolero. Question number five. Question number six, the New Zealand rugby team do the haka dance at the start of their matches. The topical music and dance, who sent Something Beautiful to Radio 2's Joe Wiley, and that was Duffy. And the Something Beautiful was a new track that she's brought out. Question eight, which couple won the 2019 series of Strictly? That was Kelvin Fletcher and Oti Mabuse. So 2 points if you've got both of those. 1 point if you've only got one of them. The country singer that sadly passed away this weekend, or last weekend, was Kenny Rogers. The 2020 Glastonbury Festival would have been celebrating its 50th anniversary this year if it hadn't been cancelled. And the artist that headlined the festival in 2019 was Stormzy. The male 1958 Cha-Cha champion of Hong Kong was Bruce Lee.
Wow.
Wow.
And the person that sold Noddy Holder his mirrored top hat was Freddie Mercury of Queen. So there's two answers there, one for each, the group and the singer. The German music and dance, which group took its name from a medieval instrument of torture? That was Iron Maiden.
Oh.
The group that took its name from the inventor of the agricultural seed drill was Jethro Tull. and the Irish group that got its name from a robot character in The Dandy was Thin Lizzy. Lou Gray was a Charleston dancing champion. So that's question number 17.
Yes.
Question 18. So that the artist was Ray Dorset and the group was Mungo Jerry. And Ray Dorset wrote Kelly Marie's number one hit. It was a hit 10 years afterwards. So the general music and dance question. So the songs here, Every Breath You Take by The Police, Chasing Cars by Snow Patrol, and Every Car You Chase was the mashup track title. And then finally, the person who sang Don't Worry, Be Happy was Bobby McFerrin. Okay, so this is a summary of the answers. There's 30 points on offer. So, Jerry, I don't know whether you want to unmute everybody.
Okay.
And we'll see.
Right.
Did anybody score more than 15?
That was fantastic. Thank
well
you,
done,
Robin.
Dan, yeah.
Thank you.
You spent a lot of time doing this. We're very grateful. Yeah. Thank you so much.
We did really badly. We got 12.
Okay. Write your results in the.
Oh, Michelle and Kevin got 16. Wow,
16.
Wow.
I got 3.
3. Well done, Christelle. Oh. That's 2 more than last time.
I got Bolero, Haka, and Falcon.
Okay, so we're going to do the last dance of tonight, and that's. Yes.
Steal the screen back, don't you?
Yes. Rob, could you stop sharing your screen so I can
share
12 for me. Oh, well done. Well done, Michelle. 12. Excellent. Thank you. Thank you very much, Rob and Diane. And we're very impressed, actually. Do one last dance. This was the beginner's class last week, so I need to get the way. It's the Va Va Voom stroll. We're going to go through it again with Emma.
Yeah.
And then we'll do it to music one last time. Okay. So move the screen. So
I'm getting dusty now. Sorry.
Actually, yes. I just. Right. How is that? Yeah. Okay. So we are going to do. We're starting with. Tap, step, tap, step, tap, step, tap, step. Okay, one more time. So it's 8 beats, 4 bars of 8 beats. Ready? And one,
right,
two,
left, right, left.
Okay, then we have.
I'm going to do it sideways. Gary's going to do it. So. Look at what Thierry's doing, but also you'll be able to see from what I'm doing.
So we're going to go heel, heel, toe, toe, heel, toe, heel, toe. One more time.
So we're doing that with our right foot.
Ready, and heel, heel, toe, toe, heel, toe, heel, toe. So from the beginning, ready, and one, two, three, four, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. That takes us to the grapevine. Now we're going to have to cheat for the grapevine because normally we move forward. So we're going to go side, cross behind, side. One more time. So we go side, cross behind, side, tap. And then side, cross behind, side, slide. Okay, once again, ready, and
side, cross behind, side, tap, side, cross behind, side, and slide. Let's add it to the beginning. Ready, and 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. And slide. So why are we sliding? Because we've got a jazz box. Jazz box looks like this. We are crossing over with our left foot and crossing with the right. Stepping to the side and forward. And again, crossing over and crossing to the side. So let's do it one more time. 1, 2, 3, 4. Cross it.
Right, left, right, left.
And again.
Right, left, right, left.
And guess what? You're ready to scroll. You were anyway. Emma was off the screen. You're ready to start again. So one last time and then to music. Ready? And 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Ready to start again? Let's do the music and dance. Let's do the music. So I've got online classes. So it's going to say va va voom and off we go.
Ladies and gentlemen, are you ready? I'm just going to go. Oh, yes, all my life. I'm going to make you move.
Now. Yay! Brilliant!
That was fab. I was watching first doing it. It was brilliant.
Right. Whew. That was good exercise. Are you still there? Shall I unmute everyone? Oh, nobody was muted anyway.
See, we all behaved. Right.
How was it? Did you enjoy it?
It was very good.
Good. Well, thank you so much for joining us tonight. This is pretty much the end of this class. And I'm actually going to stop the recording here. Oh, and no, where is it? Stop recording. Goodbye.